going to use Teachable Machine. So it's teachablemachine.withgoogle.com. And if you click on Get Started, we want an image project. And if we look here, it says best is 224 by 224 pixel color images. It's going to help to have square images. Let's just keep that in mind. So our model is going to determine whether or not someone has their mask on correctly. So we're going to make actually three classes. So we're going to have mask and no mask. And I'm going to add a third class, which would be incorrect mask. So you can name your classes or labels anything you want. We can either take pictures through the webcam, but what I've done is I've actually done a little bit of research and found some websites through looking on Kaggle. You know, so the best thing to do is go ahead and download. So if you click on download, and in fact, you do have to be create an account to do this. So if you download it, you can download all those pictures and then go through them. I ended up with a couple of different data sets. I did a search on Kaggle. I was able to find both this data set as well as another one. And I did my own set of editing. So one thing was that not all images were square. So that was the first thing I did was I took them and I made them all square. So I made a set of incorrect masked, and then no mask, you can just either use the ones that are provided. And in addition, there's all sorts of facial data sets that you can use. Inputting those, you would just upload. So say from here, I could grab, so this is my mask, you know, so I want to do about the same number of each. So let's go up to like, say 25 or so. And we can just drag and drop them in. And the same for no mask. So the first thing you want to do is click upload and then drag them in. Now, one thing is, I'm just putting this together quickly. Notice that most of mine are of women and most of them are of white women. So let's make sure that we've got people of different ethnicities and genders. So if I did upload again, so you can go ahead and look through your list. So I've got a few more males at least there, but my racial diversity is not very good. Same here. For the purpose of this demo, I'm not going to fix this, but this is something you would definitely have to go back and make sure that you've got a good, diverse data set. For now, we'll just go on to the next one. Let's go back and let's just do our third one. So let's upload some. So let's drag them in. In addition to that, you can go ahead and use your webcam. So say for mask, you know, so you can add pictures of yourself. And you would do the same for no mask and incorrect. So I might do, you know, so to add some of not wearing it correctly. And then, you know, you'd want a no mask as well. So let me also go back to no mask, webcam, pull to record. You want to have a kind of an even number. So I've got 43, I've got 42, but I've got 60 of these. So let me delete some to get an even number of samples for each label. Now I've got, you know, a reasonable similar amount. You're going to train it. It will take a few minutes. It tells you not to switch tabs or move. You have to stay on that window. And then, okay, so no mask. So you should be able to test mask. So still not very good with, okay, incorrect. It's got it when I've got down here. So this is a start. Obviously, we would refine this, but this will at least show us what we're going to do. So the next thing we're going to do is export our model. So you're going to come here and we're going to say, upload my model. It will tell you it's uploading and we've got to wait till it is completely uploaded. Okay, and we're going to say copy.
And you need to copy and save this URL because we're going to need this when we get to coding. So save it, say, in a text doc or a Word doc for safekeeping because you will need it later.
Okay, so I've got my model. It's okay, and I probably want to do more testing. But let's say I don't get it all done today. I definitely want to save it so that I can come back to it at a different point and keep working on it. So here, if we go, download project as file. And it's going to download it as a project.tm. You'll see, in this case, it's project 3, but
rename it something appropriate, save it on your computer, and then you can reload it back into Teachable Machine and update your model.
Okay, so here's my microbit. Mine is in a little protective case, but here's your A and B. And I'm also going to use this adapter to make it easier to access the pins. You can also use alligator clips, but I'm going to use this with a breadboard that I've just got mounted in this black case. So you first attach this to the breadboard. And then you can access all the pins. And then your microbit inserts there, and then it's all connected. Now I'm using this servo, this little micro servo, and it comes with a bunch of different attachments, but I'm just going to use this simple one and pop it on there. And I need to extend that because I want to be able to open a door, so I'm just using this plastic straw. I'm just going to shorten it and then attach it using masking tape. So this is just my first prototype. So it's a little bit messy, but it's going to show us proof of concept. So the servo has three wires, a brown, which is the ground, red, which is power, and orange, which is going to be attached to the pin that goes to the microbit. This is not going to plug into this, so we need some other wires. So I've actually got a set of female and a set of male. So the female are the ones that are going to be attached to the pins here in the board. So again, brown is ground, red is power, orange I'm going to attach to pin 0, so that's how I'm attaching these. And then because these are both female, we're going to disconnect them up with a male connector. And if you use wires of the same color, it makes it a lot easier. And so now we have it all attached, and we can attach it to our little door mechanism. And so what I ended up doing also is just practicing with my code. With the servo, the range is 0 to 180 degrees. And so I ended up just playing to see what it would take here on my little door to get it to open and close. And so it just took a lot of trial and error to get the right numbers between 0 and 180 to have it be closed and open. So this is pretty rough, so that what I did then was take my little straw attached to my servo, and I cut a hole in this box and attached my extension here to this little, what I'm calling my door, on the box. And then I just left the other side down. The idea will be this will be like a door. And then I have my micro bit here attached, and it will sit up like this. So we have kind of a little system here, which is the door and the micro bit. To do this, we're using Stretch 3. And within that, they've got lots of great extensions. So the two that I used are Microbit More. So I added this particular extension in, and TM2 Scratch. So this is going to allow us to use our AI model to determine whether I'm wearing my mask or not. And then the Microbit is going to allow us to interact with the Microbit. So those are the ones that I use. And then once you add them in, you can see TM2 Scratch. These are the blocks for TM2 Scratch. It understands your AI model once you give it the image classification model, which we've copied over from Teachable Machine. And then if we go to Microbit More, there's another set of blocks there. And really what I've used here is the servo motor. So setting the pin and whatever pin we connected it to. In our case, we connected it to pin 0. And we can set it to an angle between 0 and 180. So you can drag this out and you can set that to anything. So this is how I decided to code this. So we're going to trigger that the user will check on using button A on the micro bit to say, okay, I'm ready to be checked to see if I'm wearing my mask. Pin 0 is what I've connected to the servo to. And after playing around, I figured out that 110 was the angle for the servo to have my door closed or shut. So that's where I wanted to reset it to. I have two variables. One is mask count and then last label. So the labels are going to come in as either mask, no mask, or incorrect mask. So I want to make sure that I get 5 mask labels in a row. So that's why I've got that. So I'm going to keep incrementing the mask count each time. And when I get 5, then I'll say, okay, you're wearing your mask correctly. I've got my image classification model to my Teachable machine, the one that I just built with the pictures of masks and incorrect and no masks. Then I'm just turning the classification on. And then I said, okay, every 1 second, let's classify. So it's going to be taking a video. So if I go down here and I'll turn the video on. So here's my face now. And so every 1 second, it would classify my face to see whether or not I have my mask on. So I'll just turn that off for now. And then on the microbit, I'm going to just display ready. So ready meaning, okay, show your face and let's see if you're wearing your mask. So then what we've got up here is, and this is with the TM2 extension, when I receive an image label. So that's saying when it's going to receive any of them. And because it's configured with my AI model, my 3 labels that I gave in Teachable Machine were mask, no mask, and incorrect mask. So it's going to give one of those 3. But I'm saying when I get any of those, so I'm basically saying, is it mask? And was the last one a mask also? Then I'm going to increment my mask count by 1. And just so that I can see, I'm going to have my little sprite say which particular label showed up. And if I reach the mask count of 5, then I'm going to just say, well done. And then I'm sending a broadcast message to myself. So what I wanted to do is just separate out the part about when I get a successful wearing of the mask for 5 seconds. And then I've also got the set last label to the image label. So no matter which label comes in, I want to make sure that I track which of the 3 labels it is. But when I broadcast open door, then I'm going to come over here to this when I receive open door. And that's a broadcast message I set up. And I'm going to set pin 0 to the angle of 20 degrees. And that's enough on my particular setting on the servo to open up the door. I'm going to turn classification off so it stops trying to take pictures and classify anymore. And I put a little heart on the display on the micro bit. And then I'm waiting 8 seconds just to kind of leave the door open. And then I'm going to turn the servo back to 110, which will close the door,
cleared the display, and then set mass account back to zero. And then what's going to happen is the next person will have to come and press button A again.